Hi everyone, it's Yanis here with a new episode to help you build better daily structure and be in control of your life. Planning is one of the most fundamental things that help individuals and businesses to achieve certain goals. When you have a schedule in place, it will keep you accountable and you will know exactly what to work on at any given time. So today, I want to share my 6-step weekly planning process that I use to ensure that I stay productive and achieve my goals. If this is your first time on this channel, then make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon to get updates on my latest videos about time management and productivity. Also, check out my free productivity resources that has helped thousands of people to set better goals, make better decisions, and build solid structure in their life. I have been sticking with weekly planning for about 7 to 8 years now, and I find it very beneficial to plan for a week ahead. To plan my time, I use 2 tools. One is Google Calendar, where I do my time blocking, and second tool is my journal, where I write down little things and log my time. I do my weekly planning on Saturday mornings between 6 a.m. and 7:30, and I do it first thing in the morning because that is when I have clear head and I'm full of energy. So let's go ahead and go through my weekly planning process, and I'll show you every step of how I do it. Number one, look at goals and vision. The first thing that I do when I sit down to do my weekly planning is I open my quarterly goals document. My goals are indicating things that I want to achieve, and that is helping me to plan the right activities in my weekly schedule. Think about it, how can you plan if there is no end result? Planning without goals means that you are simply filling up your time with random activities. This is why I always look at my goals first, even before I have opened my weekly schedule and started to plan anything. Number two, review previous week. Once I have reviewed my goals, I then start my weekly planning process with looking back at how my previous week went. So I open my Google Calendar and look through my previous week's time blocks. I usually update my time blocks in real time so that I can see what I've been doing every day. Then I log my feedback in my weekly report. I will explain more in detail about weekly report in upcoming sections. Number three, identify priorities for the upcoming week. After I finish my previous week's review, I then focus on what is a key activity or activities that I have to accomplish in the next week. For example, at the moment, my big focus is on content production, so that is one thing that I will be noting down in my weekly report. Another thing that I'm working on is an email sequence that I want to prepare for my business, so that will go on a list as well. Number four, plan out the weekly time blocks. The next step in the process is to block out all upcoming week with the time blocks in a way that will help me to achieve my goals. So I start with blocking out time for content production first, as this is activity that will directly help me to achieve my quarterly goal. When I plan out my time blocks, I always try to block out first part of the day with the most important activities, as that is when my energy levels are high. So I would plan to work on script writing, planning, and decision making in the first part of the day, and admin related tasks like email and content review in the second part of the day. Number five, fill in the weekly report. This is something I do throughout my planning process, starting when I go through my previous week's plan. I have a little weekly report that I have integrated into my Google Calendar, and it helps me to address the most important points that I need to focus on. Here are some things that I have included in my weekly report. How was my performance, focus, and time investment? How was my energy levels previous week? And how was my team performing previous week? What are some main things that I achieved in a previous week? What are some of the main things that I will be achieving the next week? Once I answer these questions, I know how things are going and where I am heading. This helps me to stay on track towards my goals. Number six, update journal. And the last step of my planning process is to update my journal. Here I update my upcoming week's dates and activities that I need to do. The big picture I can see in my Google Calendar, like client meetings, content production time blocks, etc. But my journal serves more for little things and notes that I'm making along the way, like paying wages on Thursday or ordering my protein on Friday. And that is pretty much the whole planning process that I'm going through every week. It takes about 90 minutes of my time, but it is definitely worth it. I would also like to share some additional things that you should keep in mind when you're planning your weekly schedule. First, be flexible. Your schedule is not set in stone. Many people give up on planning because they can't stick with their schedule. If you make a plan and then something big changes, then don't hesitate to adjust your plan, as that will help you to stick with it. Second, include buffer times. So many people try to plan out every single minute of their day and then they give up because they can't follow through. I personally include at least 1 hour buffer time every day to ensure that I can stick with my schedule even when something unexpected happens. Third, theme your days. To approach your days with more intentionality, a great strategy is to theme your days where you focus on specific tasks. For me, Tuesdays and Thursdays are for content production, Saturdays are for strategic planning and admin tasks, and Sundays I have a buffer time and time for rest. Fourth, embrace rituals. A great way to start and finish your day is to build rituals packed with healthy habits like stretching, reading, meditating, and practicing gratitude. Habits like these will increase your productivity and performance, so you'll be able to complete your daily tasks, finish projects on time, and eventually achieve your goals. I hope that you enjoyed this video and I was able to give you a quick overview of my weekly planning process, and it will help you to develop your own unique planning style. If you enjoyed this video, I would really appreciate if you could press the like button, as this will help the video reach more people and spread the message.